was only said that to me today. Like, nobody talks like that to somebody like me, you know. Young one today on the street. She says, do you want to chat for a few minutes? She was working with Amnesty. You go on pretending you'd know nothing about it. Oh, really? And I said to her, where are you from? And she said, Leitrim. And I said, where are Leitrim? She said, Drumahair. I said, I'm from Leitrim. She said, where are you from? I said, Tom Shambo. Oh, no. Anyway. We all have it, but I certainly have the voice, the little voice in the head when you look in the mirror that says, you're fucking idiot. You know, no matter what you do, it's there as a kind of a negative thing that you try and battle with. I agree with Beckett, who said there is nothing as funny as complete misery, and he proved in all his playing. Because you can't be stopped telling stories. And sometimes it's very important to tell the story. In the post office, I had an urge to share this with a woman in the queue beside me. But she had her own worries. If I hear any more guff on the television about the banks, she said, I'll throw the set out the fucking window. I mean, the first question you asked about, like, if it's a depressed book, then it's a happy book, how is that? Maybe it's because part of the book, that book was my therapy, to just accept and put it out there to people that I have fucked up everything.
How?
Well, everybody...
You're on the fucking television.
I know. I know. your
book is number one in the charts. The failure. Oh, the fucking failure of it. Fuck me.
I didn't know that when I was writing it, son.